أهلا وسهلا.
دكتور،
well, first, thank you very much for the interview. I'm Dr. Ahmed Watidey, senior consultant cardiac surgeon, associate clinical professor of cardiac surgery. I've been in the field of cardiac surgery for more than 30 years. Wonderful. It's a great conference, one of the biggest, if not the big, the biggest conference in the cardiac field in Egypt. It has been going for, I think it's close more than 15 years now. And every year you see a huge number of physicians in the cardiac field and also from other subspecialties. A lot of visitors, a lot of international figures from Europe, America, Asia, and the Arab world. It's a very good chance to update the physicians and the surgeons with the new or modern advances in the field of cardiac cardiology and cardiac surgery. And in the same time, it's good to meet the experts and exchange the knowledge and information and experience. That's a very good question, and it will take some time, but you know, every year there is something new in every and each part of cardiac surgery. The field of transcatheter intervention and that producing the valve with the catheter rather than surgery is a very rapidly advancing field. And it's called the TAVI, transcatheter aortic valve, or TAVR, transcatheter aortic valve replacement. And instead of opening the chest and putting the patient on the heart-lung machine, which we call open heart surgery, now it's done by catheter. It has been introduced first in man since 2002, and it has been advancing very rapidly. A lot of techniques, a lot of technologies developed for such a technique. Is now in the world, all over the world, I think more than 125,000 patients who underwent such a procedure. It is done in Egypt. It can be done through the femoral artery, which is the artery of the thigh, and like the cardiac catheterization. And it takes a short time. The patient can go home rapidly after 1 or 2 days. Without anesthesia, in very short ICU stay and very accelerated recovery. So that's a very good area of the modern technologies and techniques in cardiac surgery. The other one is the minimally invasive cardiac surgery, which is something also helps a lot of patients. It entitles the use of the scope and the small openings, which we call minimally invasive. Instead, or rather than opening the chest, we open a small opening in the chest on the lateral side of the chest, or one or two openings where you can fix a valve or a congenital defect in the heart, or you can also do coronary artery bypass surgery. So it's another technique which also very helpful to patients, and we do it for the patients who request it and who cannot, in whom we cannot open the chest for any reason, or they don't like opening the chest anteriorly and they like the small openings, like in ladies and young girls, in some athletes and people who require such a technology. It's also had been there for a long time and it's advancing. It's very good for the patient and the good rapid recovery as well. There is also a technique which is called beating heart surgery. It has been there for the last 20 years. It's still in practice. It's still around 20 to 30% of patients who undergo coronary artery bypass surgery. We don't stop the heart. We use the beating heart surgery. We do the bypass while the heart is beating. We can do it from the sternotomy, from the opening the chest anteriorly, or we can do it from the side, which is called mini thoracotomy or lateral mid cap, which is a very good technique also for for cardiac surgery patients. There is another area advancing also, which is we call it surgery for arrhythmias. Usually patients who comes with the mitral valve and they need mitral valve surgery, they have what is called atrial fibrillation or chronic atrial fibrillation. In those patients, we do what is called AF ablation or atrial fibrillation ablation during repair of the valve or during replacement of the valve. It treats this arrhythmia with a success rate of more than 70 or 80%. It depends on the technique. We can use cryo ablation, we can use radio frequency, we can use ultrasonic, we can use another sources of energy, but it is another area which is very, very good and helpful to patients. Another technique also, which we has been there for a long time and it is always advancing, and there is always modern techniques, which is the mitral repair or aortic valve repair, which can be done whether by classic surgery or by the mini incisions, the mini minimal invasive surgery. Repair is very good for the patient. If the valve is repairable, it needs a special experience. It needs also special training. And I think it helps a lot of patients because the left ventricular function is preserved and is better compared to those who in whom we replace the valve. Also, repair of the aortic valve is something also you need to select the patient. It's very good, very helpful. One of the biggest advantages is to avoid the anticoagulation, which is the use of anticoagulation for life. Another big advantage or major advantage is to avoid the incidence of thromboembolism, which happens in those with mechanical valves. So this is just a brief about the modern techniques and technologies in cardiac surgery.
Thank you so much for being with us today.
You're welcome.